Hi class, welcome to another tutorial on CS384. This time we will be actually looking on the try and except clause along with the syntax. So we have the standard clear statements. Ubuntu and Mac can use the clear part. So I have numerator as 10, denominator as 0. I am keeping the same thing which I kept in the previous program so that the interpreter throws an error here, right? So when I execute this, you can see line number 7, which is this line, throws an error, 0 division error. Right? Obviously, because 10 cannot be divided by 0. Right? So what Python says, whatever line has caused an error, try to keep them into a try block. Right? So this line caused me an error. Obviously, since this line caused me an error, the print division will also be an error. So what I do, I just cut these lines and I keep it into the try and except clause. So see, try and except are totally opposite to each other. It is just like if and else clause. If the try clause executes, else except won't be execute. If the except is executing, the try won't execute. But there's a slight difference here, as we will see here. So now what I say, numerator is 10, denominator is 0. So Python interpreter, please try to execute these statements. Okay, please try to execute these statements. But if you get an error, kindly execute the except part and don't stop the execution, halting. Right, again. Python interpreter, please try to execute these two statements. If they are giving an error or an exception, just print this and continue for the remainder of the program. So now let us see what happens. I save the file and run the file. See, now there are no errors thrown. So let us see what the execution does. So I come under the try loop. I say, okay, try to execute this statement. Okay. And then it says, okay, 10 by 0 is giving me an error. So I cannot execute anything further. So the moment there is an error here, the interpreter will skip all the lines in the try statement, even if they are a proper statement. I will directly jump to the except clause and then print. There was some error in the try clause, which is reflected here. I exit the block, right? You can see the indentation here. I exit the block and then I execute multiplication. Multiplication can happen 10 into 0, which is 0. And then I print, have a good day, right? So in this, you can actually see how try and except has helped you. First, it did not break the program. Unlike the previous line where it was directly aborting the program, it did not break the program. So you handled the exception also, and you did not require to break the clause, break the program in middle, right? Just for a demo, let me just show you the moment there will be an error. I say, let's say, hi there. So this line basically has no issues, but the moment you encounter an error, okay, let me just see here. I will just keep an apple a day keeps the doctor away. So when I come to the try block, I will first execute this line. So this executes well. Let us see. See, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. The moment you encounter an error in the division statement, all the future try statements will not be executed. See, this will cause an error because denominator was 0. It will cause an error. So the hi there is not printed. The moment there is an error here, I directly jump to the except clause and print. There is some error in the try clause. You can even have your own custom statements. And then when this executes, I execute the multiplication clause and I terminate the program. So this is how try and except help us immensely in handling errors, right? That's it for this tutorial. Next, we will see how can we handle multiple and specific exceptions. Thank you.